It's jamthehype.com. Your boy Chris Chicago, South by Southwest. You already know when you're looking at this mug right here. Look at that beautiful face. Trying to look hardcore to the flow. My homie, Brother Tone. See, I always want to call you Tone, man. I always want to call you Brother Tone.
I know.
Formerly the artist, Brother Tone. Now known, respectively, as Brother Tillman. Tony Tillman. What up, Brother Tillman? What up, Bishop Tillman?
What's up, man? What's up, man?
How you doing, buddy?
I'm good.
I'm excited to have you on right now on our live broadcast. Actually, if you're viewing it right now, you're probably checking it out on YouTube.
Yeah.
But you got some news to drop right here, man.
Yeah, man.
Do you want to just get right into the news?
Yeah, I mean,
it's exciting news, man.
Yeah, it don't matter to me.
You're working on new music.
I am. A whole album.
And we had a chance to chat about it, and it's going to be like, this album's going to be like legit.
Yeah.
You're taking it back to your roots, bro.
Yeah. Yeah.
So talk to us about it, man.
It's definitely very introspective. You know what I mean? It's me. It's my story. It's my life. It's out of the box, I would say.
Yeah.
So out of I hate saying the Christian box. You know what I mean?
Brother Tone is announcing that he is not a Christian hip hop artist.
No, I'm a Christian hip hop artist.
He is a hip hop artist who's a Christian.
No, I'm both.
Tony Tillman is saying that Christian hip hop is corny.
No, I don't say that. Only corny people say that.
Oh, did I say that? No, that's not what I meant.
Not that, man.
That was amazing. I love that you just said that.
It dawned on me after I said it. I was like, oh, no, not that way.
Yeah, but those people don't even, I mean, they're probably never on jamthehype.com, so they'll probably never see this interview.
I mean, it doesn't matter.
They're not messing with Chris Chicago or Tony Tillman, you know what I'm saying?
Yeah, it's cool.
All right, so you're taking it out of the box.
Yeah, out of the box in the perspective of, for years doing music, I felt like I was kind of taught that doing Christian rap, you should do it a certain way.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? So when I say out of the box, out of that teaching, you know, I took it out of that box, and actually, I'm doing it the way.
Dude, I've been rolling with you for a long time, though. You know that.
Yeah.
In fact, I mean, some of my favorite Christian hip hop songs ever, "Saving Hollywood."
Yeah.
"I Preach Christ." I mean, those are like classic Brother Tone songs.
They are.
And you know what we should do for those who know who Tony Tillman is, but they don't know about the Brother Tone days.
Yeah, I think we should.
They don't. You think we should do it?
Yeah.
All right, we're gonna do this. Check out this video. Was it the first single ever, or the second single? No.
Would I Preach Christ?
Yeah.
Yeah, that's the first.
That's the first single, yeah, right? Let's check out the first song this homie ever dropped.
Yeah.
The video. You were in Baltimore for this one.
Yeah, Baltimore.
Let's check it out. Maryland. It's I Preach Christ, Brother Tone. Check this out.
Go back.
Omega. Yeah. Let's do it. Let's do it. The interpretation, man. I preach Christ, man. Nothing more, nothing less, man. Yeah. The D-Wall Kings, man. That's who I rep, man. Ain't no shame about it, man. I'm about to interpret truth to you, man. Intro, let's do it. I don't need no hook for this track. I scream Psalms 23 and leave a Mac and light. Joel was back. I scream Christ cause it's necessary. Without them homies, it's dying, looking like Jay-Z fading to black. So I come to change perspectives. I call him preaching to Christ, the true Messiah who don't hang from your necklace. I might do one, check this. The juice is unsecure and wide open like the borderlines of Texas. I see you dipping curves in your Lexus. Sin got you covered from your feet to where your neck is. So we like Abraham riding the rescue lot, preaching the good news to homies that's on your block. Cause homies hustling, hurriedly running against the clock. In custody of iniquity, check the time on your watch. You can tell that it's time for change. Don't sell out to God and let us love nickel and dime you, man. I don't need no hook for this. All I need is the Holy Ghost and 66 books for this. I got a cure for the crook with this. I preach Christ to the masses and get you off the hook with this. I don't need no hook for this. All I need is the Holy Ghost and 66 books for this. I got a cure for the crook with this. I preach Christ to the masses and get you off the hook with this. I preach Christ the Nazarene, daughter, son of the blessed. The incarnated word of God seen in the flesh. So when he speak, we listen, cause his words bring life. Cause he's more than a prophet, he ain't David correct, but he's the truth and the life. We down to die for the dude, believe in the good news. We don't follow for the fool, but we follow with his zeal. For our sins he was bruised, and we follow cause of faith. No pictures, no clues. We surrender like war criminals, knowing what he do, like walking on water. We don't even say he was the shoes. We promote mankind, except the father of time, who tossed the demons to swine, who turned the water to wine, who get a sight to the blind. When others want to stone you for adultery, he kneel in the sand and draw a line. Yeah, we throw the crosses up like it's a Piru sign. Listen, homie, you need the blood, but not the Damu kind. No, I don't need no hook for this. All I need is the Holy Ghost and 66 books for this. I got a cure for the crook with this. I preach Christ to the masses and get you off the hook with this. I don't need no hook for this. All I need is the Holy Ghost and 66 books for this. I got a cure for the crook with this. I preach Christ to the masses and get you off the hook with this. Yeah. I preach Christ, man. The true Messiah who don't hang from your necklace. Yeah. The one who walked on water, man. The one who fed a multitude with bread and fish, man. Talking about the one who turned water into wine. Who wasn't married to Mary Magdalene. The real Christ, man. The true Messiah. Yeah.
See, that's what I'm talking about. I mean, that's when I became a Brother Tone fan right there.
Yeah.
The whole I Preach Christ, the Saving Hollywood days. I mean,
yeah.
That dude. When you were doing that at that time period, like, there was no one better. Like, everyone will say this, like, we hate the fact that not a lot of people knew what was going on. Like, when you say, oh, man, Brother Tone, that sound was at the time, you know what I mean?
No, I appreciate
it. You were the best.
Well, you know,
if Christian hip hop was at its point in history, then can you imagine? Like, I'd be talking to Lecrae right now.
What? What?
No, I'm not saying I'd be talking to Lecrae Moore right now, but I'd be talking to, you know what I mean? I'd be talking, like, you wouldn't even be granting me this interview right now. You'd be like,
nah.
Christian, I ain't going to talk to that. I ain't got time for that. Because you would have been, like, the biggest artist in Christian hip hop. That's how dope that your music is.
I mean,
that's how much I respect you.
That wouldn't change who I am. It wouldn't change my personality, though.
I'm messing with you.
Yeah.
You're a good dude.
I mean, I'm cool.
Yeah, you're cool.
Yeah, I'm cool.
You are cool. Hold on real quick. Yeah. I just got word from the people upstairs that Doc Watson has phoned in, and he said...
What'd Doc say?
Doc says to make sure that you announce the name of your album right here live on the
Doc said that. Doc said
Jam
that.
The
Doc
Hype said YouTube that. Channel.
Okay.
Man.
I kind of got a feeling somebody's impersonating Doc.
It's Mad Hate. Or what was his old persona that he used to do?
Young Hate.
Young Hate.
Young Hate.
Young Hate who just phoned in.
It was Young Hate.
Young Hate said to drop the album name.
Nah, man. Can't do that, man.
So what else is going on? You're excited for the album to drop?
I am. I'm ready for it to drop.
You're in the studio. You're working on mixes.
Yeah.
How many songs do you have lined up for the album?
Well, I mean, I don't know. I know I have right now ready to go songs. 10. 10.
So you
10
got
songs
10 online.
Say,
you know, 10. 10 songs.
I know
are
these
coming,
are gonna make it.
Ready to go for the album.
Yeah, yeah. And I recorded way more than 10.
Yeah.
You know, I recorded more than 10. But
and who are you working with in the studio?
Me, D Minor, Derek Minor.
Oh yeah, Derek said yesterday. Here at South by Southwest that he was the executive producer on the album.
Yeah, he's A&R on the record.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? So
that's a good dude to have there, man.
Yeah, it's a good dude to have in the pocket, man.
Yeah.
Have on your squad.
What is your favorite song so far that you've done? What is it called? And what is it about?
It's called...
Doc says it's okay to talk about your favorite song on the album.
A song called No Lie.
Okay. And what's the content of the song?
Content of the song is No Lie. It's me saying, hey, this is where I come from.
It's probably okay to talk about this song because you performed it, aren't
yeah,
you?
Yeah.
Yeah, so, okay.
I performed it. So the album, you know, the No Named album is I feel like over the years, people hadn't got to know, you know, who I am as a person.
Right.
You know what I mean? So I think people kind of have this perception of who I am based on the music that they've heard from me.
Yeah.
But I feel like it was time for me to kind of put music out there that expresses who I am as a person.
I can't even wait to hear it.
You know, so.
And I feel bad because you think I'm a jerk.
Nah,
and we'll talk about it on camera because the first thing you said to me when we saw each other here at South by Southwest was the fact that I did not text you back.
You didn't text me back, man.
I thought I did, though. I promise I thought I texted you back.
Nah, you know.
And I was like, yo, Tone, I can't wait to hear the music. You're like, man.
Man, forget that.
I don't even roll with you no more. Nah, all because I forgot to text you back.
You my dude, man. You know
it was only like a week ago. So we don't get into like jerk status until like after 2 weeks, right?
Some people.
Oh.
Some people.
You roll like 24-hour, 48-hour status.
I'm an ex-gang member.
Oh.
So it's like once you're in the circle, you're in the circle.
Yeah.
So, yeah, it takes a lot before you're out of the circle.
How many years were you in gangs?
I was in the gang.
Were you involved with that? Like, how old were you when you got in?
I was 12.
12 years old?
12 years old.
And how did you get into the gang? Did they?
I had an older uncle who was about 3 years older than me.
Yeah.
And I didn't know anything about gangs, but he always let me hang with him and his homeboys. And then they did this documentary called Gangbanging the Little Rock. And when they did that documentary, instead of, like, making me run from gangs, it actually put me on.
Yeah.
I started seeing elements of the movie that said, oh, wow, my uncle do that. Oh, wow, my uncle does that. Yeah. Oh, he says that. Oh,
I remember that because I always thought Little Rock was this nice little community.
Country, everybody running around, horse and buggies.
Arkansas. Yeah.
Natural state.
Yeah, and then I saw gangbanging in Little Rock, and, man, that scared me.
Yeah, and see, for a lot of people, it did. You know,
I was, as Thizzle would say, I was scared.
I was scared.
Yeah.
Yeah, for me, it was like, how do I be down with that? Like, how can I be a boss? So I went to my uncle.
Did you get, you were part of the bloodline, so you were already in, or did they have to bring you in?
I was a Crip. My uncle was a Crip. I wanted to be a Crip, but I had to show heart. I had to go and do something.
Yeah.
I don't want to talk about it, but
Of course.
But I had to do something to show that I had some heart.
Yeah.
You know what I mean?
And so 12 years old, you became a Crip. And how long were you in that lifestyle?
Until I became a Christian, which I was about 20.
And how did you become a Christian? Like, what was that process like?
I think we got the time for it. I started having these weird, I didn't go to church growing up.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? But I started having these weird dreams of dying, people killing me. And then I always heard of stories of, like, you know, Jesus and God and how God is going to end the world. But there were so many different stories living in the hood that you don't know where, you know, the lie ends and the truth begins. But I started having this reoccurring dream of fire coming from the sky. And so that kind of started making me God conscious of feeling like God is trying to say something to me. I didn't know what. And then
you apparently knew of a God.
Yeah, of course.
So there was some kind of seed in your life somewhere.
Yeah, yeah.
Maybe grandma or someone was going to church or something.
Yeah, well, my dad, mom, she was religious.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, she was real religious.
Yeah.
But I never went to church with her.
Yeah.
You know, I actually used to get talked about because I wouldn't go to church.
Yeah.
You know, but anyways, I ended up catching an attempted murder charge.
Oh, and, man. Okay.
So,
how old were you when you got the attempted murder charge?
I was 17.
Yeah.
So at 17, I got an attempted murder charge. I sat in jail, and then I got out on the signature bond. My mom had to sign a signature bond because we couldn't afford money.
Yeah.
Well, we didn't have money. And so on the way to the courthouse from the police station, it was about an hour drive. So sitting in the back of the police car, the police officer was playing something of the Book of Revelation.
Really?
Yeah, it was the weirdest thing. So I'm hearing elements. I'm hearing stuff about God and then this lamb, which was crazy to me because I'm like, what the crap is this lamb have to do with God? You know,
right.
It was weird. But then there was, you know, certain parts about the stars falling from the sky and things like that, and automatically kind of referred to my dream.
You like,
I'm like, having
what?
A dream. So I asked him, yo, what's that you listening to? And he's like, it's the Book of Revelation. And I'm like, who wrote that? You know, and he's like, oh, it's in the Bible. And then I'm confused more because I'm like, how is the book in the book? You know, and so we went back and forth. He's trying to explain it. So he finally told me it's the last chapter of the Bible. So I was placed on house arrest. While I was on house arrest, I would read the Book of Revelation every single night, like literally all 22 chapters every single night. And that kind of started giving me, like, every time I get to, like, the last few chapters about, you know, the lake of fire and hell, I would always think, that's actually me there. And I didn't want that to be me, but I didn't know how to escape it. And it wasn't until, like, a few years later that I ended up going to a church or whatever. And when I went to this church, I kept coming back because of a girl that I was trying to pursue. And the pastor preached a sermon on Matthew 24, and that sermon actually tied connected the dots for me between, you know, how do I escape out of hell? He ended up preaching the gospel.
Yeah.
You know what I mean?
Awesome.
And showing me that Jesus was the way. So
that's dope.
Yeah, man.
I wish we had more time to,
to
hear
man.
More. So we're, you know, we're going to do this again. We'll have you on the syndicated radio show.
Yeah, man.
We're going to talk about the new album a lot more as we get closer to the release date.
Yeah.
We'll play new music on the website, on the radio show.
You had it.
We'll hear. We'll see videos, I'm sure, lyric videos. I mean, we know how RMG does it.
Yeah,
so,
man.
So it's Tony Tillman, the new album. They say you can say the name of the album now.
Yeah, it's called A New Album.
New album is dropping. When is it dropping? Do you got a release date?
Yeah, this year, 2015.
Dropping soon. Here soon in 2015. Soon. It's going to be an incredible album from what I hear. Yeah. I'm excited for it. Tony's a good dude. He's a good artist. Make sure that you do not sleep. I'm a homie right here because it's going to be a dope project.
Yeah, man.
I know that. I can say it that. Is. So, all right, jamhype.com.